Vernon Lynch, introduce who's here with us.
Yep. Brandon Bad Dudes Lynch, 154 pounder right here, baby.
You're coming off a series of great wins. What's your record now?
12-1-1.
Amazing. You're supposed to fight Terrell Gouche.
Yes.
If that fight doesn't happen, because Charlo just got injured, would you like to fight Tim Zoo?
I'd love to.
We would take that fight, yes.
I'd love to.
Yes.
Tim is very talented. You're very talented. It'd be a big fight.
It'd be great.
And he just fought Terrell Gouche.
Yeah, exactly. Both great fighters, man, but I know I got what it takes for winning the gym day in, day out.
Oh, I see what every gym in LA, you're working your backside off. You're working very hard every day. No shortcuts.
It's a new game, man. So, yeah, man, I'm prepped. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to get it hard. So, you know, whenever we get that call,
I got disappointed that so many people thought that Charlo was faking it. Why would a fighter about to make millions that from his own pocket pays for training camp fake it a broken hand? It makes no sense. These people are just really foolish.
I don't know why people would fake that. I mean, he's here to fight. And, you know, those guys, they don't play games like that. Charlo's made a real deal, man. Like, there's no faking in them. You know what I mean?
What you see is what you get. They're face value. They're not the Hollywood game, the smile in your face and play.
That's an exciting fight. That was slated to be a very exciting fight. But we'll see. We'll see what happens.
When are you supposed to fight?
That card.
January 28th. So you haven't gotten word that it got canceled. That means it may still be on.
Right.
Which is great.
I'm trying to find out today.
Continuing to train. Just after fighting the 28th still. Like I said, we're ready to rock and roll. Doing the work. So I'm ready to show the world.
For us, it doesn't matter. If it's, you know, listen, if we were able to get that call and we could fill in, it's great money. Hey, man, this is what we do.
Step up.
Right? You step up. And guess what? It's just an opportunity to shock the world. I look at Tim Zoo. Listen, man, he showed up in America and made it. Look where he's at real quick. You know?
He's very talented.
He's very talented.
Nice person, too. Chill.
And we're not overlooking our opponent. You know, our opponent treats everybody like they kill us. Everybody's a killer. So, you know, we just here to fight, man, make it happen. We're excited to be able to be like the fight on Showtime, fight on television.
But last question. Tell me, like, the five biggest names you sparred over your career. Because you shared the ring with a lot of legends. I was there for that one.
All right. Alex Gvozdik, the nail.
Gvozdik, former world champion at 168, 175. Very talented. Yeah.
That was crazy. That was
yeah, he's the hardest hitting guy in boxing. One of them.
He's a big dude.
Dude, he's big.
He is big. And he hits very hard. I know that because I've seen him in Oxnard. He one time sparred Brandon Rios, punched him. Brandon was in a neck brace for 2 weeks. Like whiplash. No, he hits that hard.
Yeah.
He's very talented. Him and Bitterbayev rematch. I'd love to see that.
Same senior, Gabe Rosado, got a lot of rounds with him, a lot of people. Jason Quigley.
Got a few rounds with Terrell Gouche.
And now you're supposed to fight him. What's it like to fight someone you sparred?
I think fighting somebody that you sparred is even more difficult than fighting somebody that you never worked with before because you have expectations. I know for me, I am nowhere near the same person as the last time you sparred. And I know Terrell is probably the same person either.
No, Terrell's gotten, they both have gotten so much better that it's a really good fight.
It's exciting. So, tell everybody where to follow you.
Follow me, Brandon Lynch, B-R-A-N-D-Y-N, Lynch underscore Lynch.
And look out, hopefully, I hope you still fight in 28.
So do I.
Stay tuned. Ellie Sickback reporting.